Sure, so with a uptick in our mosquito population, there's a number of diseases that mosquitoes transmit, so we may see an increase in their disease incidence. So West Nile is one that comes to mind, but also all the equine encephalomyelitis, equine infectious anemia, anything that's transmitted by a biting insect. West Nile is a disease that we really don't want to mess around with. It actually has about a 35% fatality rate, and certainly can have some long-lasting impacts because it essentially affects the neurologic system of the horse. So it's a pretty severe disease.
Obviously, the horses are bitten by a mosquito that's infected with the virus, and that's how they get the virus. And typically, if they do get sick, a lot of them will get the virus and never show any clinical signs of being ill. Those that do, they're pretty nonspecific initially, maybe a fever, reluctance to eat, depression, those types of things.
Sort of the hallmarks are the neurologic. So ataxia, hind limb weakness, you might see a little stumbling behind, they may have more trouble getting up, and kind of some neurological deficits, also muscle tremors. So anything that's really going to affect the neuromuscular system of the horse.
You know, the problem with the disease is we don't have a treatment. We just treat symptoms is what we do. So there's no cure that we have. So our best, as far as method of controlling it, is through vaccinations, really. And we do have a good vaccine. All owners should vaccinate their horses every year with this vaccine.
So it's actually a two booster series that we need to do for an unvaccinated horse. And we usually want to make sure that annually we vaccinate those horses as sort of the mosquito season starts. If populations are really severe and we're starting to see outbreaks, we might even increase to a 6-month protocol. And remember that your young horses and your older horses are more susceptible to West Nile, just like it is in people. So if you do suspect your horse has West Nile, you need to contact your veterinarian immediately. There's not any real treatment other than supportive care, but if that animal doesn't get supportive care, the chance of this being lethal is pretty high.
Do everything you can to control mosquitoes. Use some type of approved insecticide on your horse. You may want to put them up at certain times if you've got a barn that's got screens on it that will keep the mosquitoes out.
So any stagnant water, you know, overturn the buckets, you know, putting goldfish in your water troughs that can eat the larvae. Also kind of think about when mosquitoes feed most frequently. So if your horses are on pasture, there's not as much you can do about it. But if you have a place to bring them in during the early morning or evening when it's peak mosquito feeding time. So right now we don't really have a lot of reported cases, but one thing I always recommend for horse owners, at least if you want to stay aware of what diseases are in your area, there's actually a equine disease website, so you can actually go and sort of monitor. They will post reported disease incidents, so that's a great way to stay up to date.